This video is based on Pelican optimization algorithm. In this video, we will try to understand how this algorithm is working step by step using numerical example. Everything about Pelican optimization algorithm we already discussed in this video. The link is given below in the description box. You can check the link for more details. In this video, we will try to understand how this algorithm is working step by step using numerical example. First step, we have the parameter initialization phase, where we will initialize all the important parameters used in this algorithm. For example, population size, that is the total number of search agents in the current population. So here, for simplicity, we will use only 5 search agents. So we have only 5 pelicans in the current population. Next, we have the maximum number of iteration, that is how many times the loop will repeat, and after that it will display the best solution. And next, we have the test function, that is the fitness function we will use here to evaluate the agent's performance in the search space. So here we are using this test function. Here lower bound is -100, upper bound is 100. Next, we will initialize the population randomly for search agents. Here you can see we have the population size, that is 5. So we have 5 pelicans in the search space. Now we will initialize their position in the search space. Using this equation, we can initialize the population for 5 agents randomly in the search space. And for randomness, you can see here rand is used, that is a normally distributed random value within domain 0 and 1. And lower bound we have -100, upper bound that is 100. So we put the values and dimension we have 4. So here you can see the position for the first pelican, the position for the second pelican, third, fourth and fifth one. And you can see all the values you can see are within the bounds, that is in between -100 and 100. So we initialize the population for 5 pelicans in the search space randomly. Next, we will evaluate the initial population using the test function, or you can say using objective function. We will evaluate the agent's performance. Now we will apply the test function on the current position. So here you can see we have the position values for 5 search agents. Now we will apply this test function on the position. So here we are using this test function. So we'll put the value here and we obtain the fitness value for first agent, second agent, third, fourth and fifth one. Next, we will select the best individual among all, that is the best search agent having minimum value. Here you can see among all, first search agent having the best fitness value, so we will consider this as the best agent. Next, we will generate the target location randomly. So here we need a target, and then we will update other agent's position around the target. Now we will randomly generate the location for the target. Here, suppose second agent, that is the second pelican, is the target. So this is the prey, and all agents will try to search this prey location. So we will update all agents' position around this target. So we have the randomly selected target as agent 2, that is the second agent. Now we will update agent's position in the search space. So here we will perform the exploration phase, where agents will explore the search space, and using this mathematical model we will update their position in the search space. So first we will try to update the position for the first search agent, and you can see here how we can update the position for the first agent. We will check the agent fitness value, and then we will compare this fitness value with the target fitness value. And you can see here we have the target, that is second agent, and its fitness value is 6.0586. So we will compare the agent fitness value with the target fitness value. So second agent, that is the target, and its fitness value is 6.0586. Now we will check whether this condition is true or not. Right now you can see this condition is false, so we will update the agent's position using this equation. Here this is the older position for the agent, randomness, that is any random value, and then we will then we have the agent location minus target location. So we'll put all the values here. The older position value for the first agent, you can see here this one, and target position you can see here this one, and rand is any random value within 0 and 1. So put the values here, and you can see the new position for the first agent, this one, and then we will apply the test function on this position, and then we will evaluate its performance, and the new fitness value we obtained for the first agent, that is 2.7496, and the older fitness value we have 1.2297 for this agent, and the older position we have minus 80.4919, and you can see here. So this is the new position for the first agent, and this is the new fitness value. Now we will update the position for the second agent, and here we will compare the second agent fitness value with the target fitness value. If this condition is true, then we will update the agent position using this equation, else using this equation. Right now you can see here condition is false, so again we will update using this equation, and we will put the values here, and now you can see the new position for the second agent here, this one, and then we will apply the test function on this position, and we obtained new fitness value here for the second agent. Like that, we will compute the fitness value for third, fourth, and fifth one. We will compare the third agent fitness value with the target fitness value, and right now you can see here again the condition is false, so we will update using this equation, put the values here, and we obtain the new position for the third agent, and then apply the objective function on the new position, and we obtain the new fitness value for the third agent, 2.2264. Next, we will compare the fitness value for the fourth agent with the target, and again you can see condition is false, so we'll update using this equation, put the values here, and we obtain the new position and new fitness value for fourth agent. Next, we will compare the fifth search agent fitness value with the target, and again you can see condition is false, so we'll update the position using this equation. And you can see here this is the new position and new fitness value, that is 1.6417 for the fifth agent. So we updated the position for the five pelicans in the search space, and we computed new fitness value. In order to prevent the search agents moving in the non-optimal location, here we will compare the new fitness value with the older fitness value. If new fitness value is better, then we will consider that position, else we will continue the older position. This is done to prevent agents moving in the location where there is no optimal solution. So now agent final position update is done by comparing the older fitness value with the new fitness values that we recently computed in the exploration phase. Here you can see the older fitness values and the new fitness values. Now we will compare the new and old fitness value for all agent. Now you can see here for first agent, older fitness value is minimum as comparison with the new fitness value. So we will consider the older fitness value here. And for second agent, it is still same. For the third search agent, you can see the new fitness value that we obtained is better than older one, so we will consider new fitness value, or so we'll consider the new position for this agent. For fourth agent, you can see the older position is better, as you can see the older fitness value is minimum, so we will consider the older position for the fourth agent. For fifth agent, you can see the new position is better as the new fitness value is better than the older one, so we will consider the new value here. So here you can see the updated position, that is the final position for the search agent. For first, second and fourth agent, we will consider the older position, and for third and fifth agent, we will consider the new position as their new fitness value is better than older one. Next, we will perform the exploitation phase. So here, using this mathematical model, we can perform the exploitation. Here, T is the current iteration, capital T, that is the maximum number of iteration, older position, and rand is any random value. So here we will update, now again we will update the position for all agents. So we'll consider the, so here you can see the position values for five agents that we will put here, and then we will apply the fitness function again. So in exploitation phase, we will put the values in this mathematical model. For exploitation phase, you can see here the position update for the first search agent. We will put this value. So this is the position that we will put here, plus R, that is 0.2 into 1 minus current iteration divided by maximum iteration, and 2 into rand is any normally distributed random value, and then we have this position. So we'll put the value here, and we obtained here the new position for the first search agent, and then we'll apply the objective function on this position, and we obtain the new fitness value for this agent. Same we will perform for the second agent. Here we'll put this position value here and here, and we will compute the new position, then apply the objective function, and we obtained new fitness value for the second agent, that is 1.1045. Next, we will update the position for the third agent. So we'll put the value here for the position, and you can see the new position for the third agent, and then we'll compute its fitness value, apply the test function. Same we will do for the fourth agent and fifth agent. Now you can see here we have the new position and the new fitness values that we computed in the exploitation phase for the five agents. Now we will update the final position for the search agents. Again, we will compare the new fitness values with the older fitness values in order to prevent agents moving in the location where there is no optimal solution. So again, we will compare the new fitness values that we computed here with the older one, and if the new fitness values are better, then we will consider the new position, else we will consider the agent older position. So here you can see agent's older fitness value and new fitness value. For first agent, you can see the older position is better as the older fitness value is minimum, so we'll consider the older position for the first agent. For second and third agent, you can see the new fitness value that we obtained here is better, so we'll consider the new position for the second and third agent. You can see here new position is updated here. For fourth and fifth agent, older position is better. You can see here older fitness values are minimum, so they are better as compared to new one. So now for agent first, fourth and fifth, we will consider the older position, and for second and third agent, we will consider the new position that we computed here in the exploitation phase. Next, we will save the best agent position and the fitness value. So right now you can see among all the best agent is the second one, so we'll save the best agent position and the fitness value. So next we will increment the counter. Now we have the second iteration. Again, we will select any target randomly, and then we will perform the exploration phase, update agent position, and then perform the exploitation phase, update agent position, and then save the best agent. From this step, we will repeat the loop until stopping criteria is met. We will select the target randomly and then we will update the agent's position in the exploration phase, and then we will update their final position. We will compare their new and the older fitness values, and then we will check whether the new position is better or older one, and then we'll perform the exploitation phase, and then again we'll update the position for the agents, and then we'll compare the older and the new position. If older position is better, then we will consider that, else we'll consider the new one. Next, we will save the best agent position and the location, and when the stopping condition is met, we will display this best solution that we found in the previous iteration. So here you can see, so we repeat this loop until the stopping criteria is met, and when the stopping condition is met, we will stop and display the best solution that we found. So that's all about this video. If you have any questions, you can comment below, and thanks for watching this video.